the Radio Wemo Breakfast.
I promised you that if I ever got any information about your dad, I'd tell you first, right? I was paged last night. Came from your dad's office at the arcade.
So?
So? The number's been disconnected for 20 years. 2 nights before he disappeared, he came to my house. He said he was about to change everything. Science, medicine, religion. He wouldn't have left that, Sam. He wouldn't have left you.
Alan, you're acting like I'm gonna find him sitting there working. Just, hey, kiddo, lost track of time.
Wouldn't that be something?
Oh, man, ever since they announced at Comic-Con, okay, a couple of years ago, that Tron was going to be remade, or at least a new version of Tron, I've been well excited about this one. Tron Legacy is the film we're looking at with Lena Lamont. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
And you've been and seen it.
I have. I don't even think I'm their target market, and I have to say, right off the bat, it was a digital blast. It really was.
A visual feast?
Yes, it was. That's pretty much what it was, is a visual feast. Let's not get carried away with the intricacies of, what did he say, science, religion, medicine?
Did you see the original?
No, I didn't. And I was thinking about this. I think it's quite important to look at films in isolation and not always say, how does it compare to the book, or how does it compare to the original, or the first one.
But, I mean, the reason why this one has been made is because of that fandom that has grown over the couple of decades.
Yes.
Three decades, even.
And also, I mean, think about it, right? Disney put this out, and you can imagine some film executive or maybe some young person within Disney going in and pitching to them, we've got the technology now, let's make an awesome sequel around a very sort of straightforward, basic kind of plot. And that's what they've done. And technologically, it looks incredible.
Yeah.
I should say, first off, I had the privilege of seeing this in the IMAX and in 3D, and I honestly think you have to optimize your viewing experience. 2D maybe wouldn't be so good.
A good seat in IMAX?
I sat right up the back, yeah.
Yeah. I heard that it was made in both 2D and 3D, and that not all of it is 3D.
Yes, that's right. And as I understand it, and I didn't quite realise this at the time, the scenes that are in the real world, if you will, like the now, are in 2D, and it's only when young Sam goes into the grid that everything goes into 3D.
Okay,
and
that makes sense.
Not all of it in 3D, because, you know, they say at the very beginning, some of these scenes are shot in 2D for a reason, don't freak out.
Yeah.
You'll still get your money's worth, and you do.
Because I was thinking, if I was to see any movie in 3D in the near future, it would be this one, because of the whole grid type thing, you know,
it's amazing.
It fits it.
It's amazing.
Okay.
And, you know, as I say, I'm probably not their target audience. And I was sat up the back of the IMAX going, woohoo, this is awesome.
Yeah.
I was the only person doing that, which is a little disturbing. But at least I was appreciating it.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
But what about the storyline? Because there was a lot of hope that, you know, it would develop from the first film and really carry something on
and
create something cool.
It depends who you're talking to. And if you're talking to me, in my professional opinion, this is not about the storyline. And the one thing that I really felt is that the story, if you will, cobbles together the greatest stories ever told from Star Wars. There are Bible, tacit Bible references. You've got your Cain and Abel story, your creation story.
Yeah.
The immediate thing that comes to mind is Star Wars, and there's a classic line, in my view, again, I was the only person who laughed at it, but nonetheless, when Clue, who looks like the young Jeff Bridges from the original Tron, obviously, and when Sam approaches him, he thinks that this is his dad and that he's finally found his dad after 20 years. And Clue says to him, I am not your father, Sam, but I'm very pleased to see you, or something like that. And
that's cool.
Again, I thought that was clever, but...
Yeah. Jeff Bridges, I'm a big fan. How's he in this?
I think he's good.
Mm.
You know, this film is not about plot particularly, and it's not about script. Mm. And I wondered whether they thought, well, he's Oscar-winning Jeff Bridges now, so whatever lines we give him, he will pull them off.
Yeah.
And he pretty much does. There is a lot of COD philosophy. There is a lot of, we are changing science, religion, blah, blah, blah. And unfortunately, Jeff does have this tendency to say man at the end of every sentence.
Right, yeah.
The classic quote being, it's bio-digital jazz, man, like that. And he has gone very zen. I mean, he literally has gone very zen in the movie. He's living in a nice sort of white palatial sort of thing. He's meditating and trying to get back to what's real.
Yeah.
But you can't help but evoke the dude from The Big Lebowski.
Yeah.
And that's been mentioned heaps of times. Well, it is.
I've seen interviews with him, and that's him.
It pretty much is him.
Yeah.
So therefore, is it Oscar-winning Jeff Bridges, or is it just Jeff being himself? You know, who knows?
Yeah.
But he's all right in it. He's enjoyable.
Cool. Make you want to grab one of those bikes and go for a ride?
If you could. Have you ever seen anything like it?
I know.
They run around with like a baton, and you're like, oh, I don't know what's going to happen with this. Is it a scroll? Or no, it is not. It's basically chunk.
Yeah.
Pull it apart, and a bike materializes,
wow.
A light cycle materializes,
yeah.
And they leap on and off they go. Can I just say, mildly implausible, the young lad in this, Sam Flynn, right?
Yeah.
Hasn't seen his dad for 20 years. Falls down the rabbit hole, if you will, into this new world.
Mm.
Is immediately plunged into this life or death sort of situation. He has to... it's fantastic looking, but basically he's up against the greatest warriors and they think he's a program and they're trying to kill him, right?
Yeah.
He never looks fazed by any of it.
And
he gets the hang of riding the light cycles and
He's a pro straight away.
He really is a pro straight away.
Yeah.
And I mean, sure, he's a smart kid and, he's an orphan. He's had to fend for himself. He's very wealthy, but
we don't want to go through that whole process of our heroes training and years.
Well, we did in the Batman films and that was fun,
Yeah, it depends on how it's done, I suppose. Yeah.
The Batman films are a much more sophisticated concept, much more sophisticated full stop than these.
Yeah.
But Tron looks great.
Okay, Tron Legacy out of 5.
You see, I enjoyed it to the extent of a 4, but I'm going to give it a 3.5 because it's not a great film. It's not a good film, but it's a really enjoyable film. It was fantastic. I kind of feel like there was this element in it that was so stupid, but it was the coolest piece of stupid I have ever seen.
Cool.
Yeah.
That's cool. All right, 3.5 for Tron Legacy. What else have you seen in the past week that
I saw a fabulous indie film from the UK called The Disappearance of Alice Creed. It's playing at the Academy Cinemas.
Yeah.
Fantastic. It's basically a three-hander, two crooks, ex-cons who develop a plan to kidnap a rich young woman and then have her stowed away in their house and then put her up for ransom. That's it. That's your premise. There are only three actors in the whole film, and my God, it is fantastic. The scripting and the story, it's cat against mouse against cat, and the tables are turned and you never really know who to trust, and there are twists, and it's kind of still plausible in a way, and just really exciting. It's a good film, very, very worth seeing. So if you can catch The Disappearance of Alice Creed, you absolutely should.
Is it science fictiony or is
no.
It in the real world? Okay.
It's totally set in
yeah.
the real world. It's basically a crime caper.
Yeah.
And it's one of those crime capers where it starts off and you think, wow, these guys are really prepared and they know what they're doing. You know, how could this possibly go wrong?
Yeah.
Dum-dum. And then it's like best laid plans just unravel in spectacular fashion. It's gripping. It's really good. And it's good acting, good script, wonderful twists.
British or?
Yeah, totally British.
Yeah.
I think actually Isle of Man, but, British.
Kind of grim looking.
Yeah,
sort of film, like a grey kind of film.
Yes. Well, it's quite a grim film, and it certainly starts grim because you're watching the setup and then the kidnap and everything, and clearly that's not pleasant.
Mm.
But it redeems itself. It redeems itself from the grimness. So,
cool.
Yeah.
That is screening at the Academy Cinema in Auckland City.
Yes, it is.
Thanks very much, Lena Lamont. Check out your website for more reviews, which is at
lenalamont.wordpress.com.
Cool, thanks, Lena. We'll catch you in 2011.
Yeah.